The Energy Regulatory Commission urges Meralco to protect its consumers should San Miguel Corporation terminate their contract. This following the ERC's decision to reject a joint petition of the two companies seeking a temporary 30 centavo per kilowatt hour power rate hike. The ERC says Meralco should look for other remedies to avoid price adjustments.
Siyempre, ang iniisip namin bottom line yung rate impact sa consumer. Ang sa amin lang sa majority ay may provision yung mga kontrata na maaari pa nating i-explore para hindi mangyari yung kinatatakutan. Gawin muna natin yon.
For the National Association of Electricity Consumers for Reforms, Meralco has the responsibility to look for other cheap power suppliers.
O kung may mahanap man siya mas mahal, eh sinong tatamaan? Di tayo din? Kasi ipapasa din sa atin.
Papasa yun. Sa atin. Oo.
Tama yan. At kapag hindi niya nagawa yan, baka balikan ng gobyerno yung prangkisa niya. Dahil hindi niya nagagampanan yung dapat niyang gampanan.
Meralco says it will comply with the ERC decision, but it appeals for swift approval of its emergency power supply agreement to protect consumers from volatile power prices. An ancient Philippine script now on showcase in San Francisco and history is made in the Miss USA pageant. Those stories and more from our North America correspondent, Jenny Espinosa.
Good morning, guys. Here are the latest stories making headlines in the Filipino community.
We begin in British Columbia, Canada, where a record number of Filipinos are running for city council posts for the October 15 municipal elections. Amy Peacock, a longtime community organizer, is one of five. She said it's time for the seats in the council to reflect the diverse communities of Vancouver.
You are good enough, and you have a voice, and you have the credibility to put your name and run.
Like fellow city council candidate Lena Vargas, Peacock is also running as an independent. Meanwhile, Maita Santiago, who's running for the Burnaby City Council, urged Filipino Canadians to make their voices heard by electing fellow Filipinos to public office.
Dahil ang gusto po natin ay makita, it's for Burnaby, for the powers that be, to say no more that the Filipinos are an invisible community.
Aside from Peacock, Vargas, and Santiago, the two other Filipino-Canadian candidates in the municipal elections are Narima de la Cruz and Ramon Bandong Jr., both seeking city council posts in Surrey. Let's go to the Philippine Consulate in San Francisco at this ribbon-cutting ceremony that launched the month-long exhibit featuring the pre-colonial ancient Filipino script by Bayin.
I want to show the world that our ancestors were literate. They knew how to read, how to write. So regardless of if they were young, they were children, they were women, they were men.
Through this exhibition, we're hoping, of course, to promote Baybayin and, you know, for Philippine arts, Philippine culture, Philippine history, you know, to be widely known to our Filipino-American community.
And finally, history was made at the 2022 Miss USA in Reno, Nevada Monday night when 28-year-old Arboni Gabriel from Houston became the first Filipina-American to win the prestigious pageant.
Everything has been so fast-paced. I mean, day after day, it's training every day. And sometimes I can't stop and think about it and just realize how amazing this opportunity is. But when I do look at the crown, it just reminds me of all the hard work and dedication that I've put into myself. And it's just a really great feeling.
Gabriel was an early favorite, bagging the Best State Costume Award in the preliminary competition, designed by Patrick Isurena from Quezon City, Philippines. The outfit featured more than 5,000 stones and blue fabrics meant to represent Texas's state flower, the blue bonnet. Gabriel also designed much of her attire for the competition. Her outfit during the question and answer portion used patterns from her mother's wedding dress and a traditional Maria Clara collar shape. With her success, Gabriel wants to inspire fellow Filipinas.
I would encourage women, Filipina Americans too, that they can pave the way to their own success.
And those were the latest from North America. You can catch our stories online at news.abs-cbn.com/TFC News and on the ABS-CBN News YouTube channel. Back to you guys for the rundown.